Today we are going to discuss about IPv4 header fields and functions. In IPv4 header we have almost 13 fields. One by one we'll understand first. Okay, the first one is header field. So what is header field is doing? In the header field, first field is version field. So what version field is doing? This version field will talk about what version of IPv4 you are using. Is it version 4 or version 6? So version, first field talks about, is it version 4 or version 6? Because second is header length. Header length is, what is the size of the header? You see the size of the header they mentioned is 20 bytes. The standard size is 20 bytes. If you want to add extra fields, you can add it, but without adding any extra field options, this 20 bytes. Next, we have type of service. This is one field which is used for quality of service. So, what is quality of service? Like quality of service means okay, so quality of service means QoS. Now, think like this. Okay, think like this. Now you are going to send the data. Going to send the data from one PC to another PC. Okay. We're going to send the data from one PC to another PC. So this data is traveling between a router or device switch. Multiple devices will be there, right? Router, switch, you're using and you're connecting. Now you are connecting the data. This is my switch. My router R1 R2. Now I'm going to send the data. Now this data with QoS, without QoS, I'll explain what is with without QoS. Okay. The bandwidth of the link bandwidth is 2 Mbps. Link bandwidth is 2 Mbps. Okay. Now I'm going to use one. Consider this as a pipe, 2 Mbps pipe. So you are going to send data inside this. Now when you are sending data inside this tunnel or this pipe, there is no QoS. For example, there is no quality of service. No QoS. First. Then I'll talk about with QoS. Two options I'll give. QoS is there without QoS. Now PC1 has multiple types of data. For example, he has a browsing data, general browsing data. Then he has a voice call. He has a voice phone, like you have a Skype call or Skype or voice call. Then we have video also. He has been video conference, video call. So there are three types of data he is having: browsing data, voice data. Now browsing data, what is happening? Browsing data is downloading or uploading something. This 2 Mbps fully used the browsing data. I'll put the color here. The blue color is, for example, browsing data. Okay, this browsing data is fully used the bandwidth, Mbps bandwidth. Now there is no space or no bandwidth for voice or video. So what is happening? Your voice call is continuously disconnecting, or some error, some noise is coming. The quality is not good. Video call is continuously disconnecting. You know, due to this, the whole bandwidth is used from browsing data. We are downloading some movie, so the whole bandwidth is used for downloading the movie. This is without QAS, no QAS. So what I am going to do? QAS is basically bandwidth management. So bandwidth management. What I will do here, I am going to divide this into different queues. We are going to create. Okay, I'm going to create 3 queues. Okay. So the first queue is called the first queue is for. The first queue is for second queue. Third queue. 3 queues I created. I divided the 2 bandwidth, 2 Mbps link into 3. Now first I'll say 1 MB for 1 MB for and for what? For for video conference. Then 512 KB for 512 KB for what? Voice. Okay. Then 512 KB basis for KB for what? 512 KB for browsing data. Understand this? So what I did now, I took this 2 Mbps link, I divided it into, I created 3 channels or 3 queues. These 3 queues, what I did is, I have put that. Now whatever data comes, what router will do is, router will put that in that queue. So your voice and video traffic will never get dropped. The quality of the voice and video will be good. This is called quality of service. Is this understood? What is QAS? Okay, Sandeep clear, Ranjita clear. I think Ashita also clear, right? Okay, fine. Now, so to do this quality of service, we use a mechanism. The mechanism starts like this. First, it will classify the packets. Classify the data. Classification. Classification. Then, we have a policy, QAS policy. Based on the QAS policy, we will mark the data. Okay, we'll mark the data, marking is it. Then we will shape the data. How you want to shape? For example, this simple example, shaping means, you know what? Like, for example, you are using YouTube, right? When you're downloading YouTube or when you're seeing movie in the YouTube, right? You can select the pixels, 128, 420, you know. So based on the pixel, the quality of the video will change. That is shaping the video packet, video data. So shaping is basically based on our requirement, we can change the codec. Codec means coding and decoding standards. So based on this codec standard, what will happen? Your quality of service will, your quality will reduce or increase. So based on the bandwidth requirement we have, we can shape our data. So if I'm having a low bandwidth, then what I will do, I'll go for 128 kbps video. So it will be easy for me to 128 KB as a pixel, then it will be easy for me to see the video without any buffering. So this is called shaping. Then finally, scheduling. Scheduling means not scheduling and queuing. Scheduling and queuing. Putting in the queue. So whenever any data comes, what will happen? First, the router will, these all are QoS mechanism. You can say like this, what happens in QoS? How QoS will happen? This is the QoS. Function, you can say like this, QoS function. So every device, for example, take this R1 router. In R1, when the data comes from the PC, first the PC, the R1 will first classify this. This is what type of data. Now classification, if you take, we can put like this, classification. Okay, now for example, four classes will take. We generally class like this, classify. First is gold platinum, platinum class, then gold class, silver, and the bronze. Something like that. So what is platinum class? Voice. Gold class, video. Something like that. Silver class is your browsing data. Okay. Bronze is other data, which you want to put other data. So like that, we can classify the data. Now, how do I classify this data? Where this classification, this is all a policy, right? QoS classification policy. So where I'm going to classify the data, how do I know it? I will take this field. We are discussing about fields, right? So this field, QoS, type of service. In this field, there is a one code we put, that is called DSCP, differentiated services code point. It is called DSCP. DSCP means differentiated. Differentiated services code point. Is that right? So what we do here is we will have a different code point. See this. This is the field, QoS field. This, that there are, this is the different from 8 bits is there, okay. So in this 8 bits, what we do, we have different services code point, DSCP value. So based on that, we can put the critical data, flash data, immediate data, practice data, routine data. Like that, we can put the classification. So this is called the DSCP. DSCP is nothing but 8 bit data, and that 6 bits will be used for differentiated data packet, class 1, class 2, class 3. So what will happen here? So based on this classes, your packet, whenever a packet comes, first thing what it will do, it will see the class. So based on the classes, it will start differentiating. After it put the DSCP value for each and every packet, the next mechanism what it does is, based on the policy, they will mark the data. So once they mark the data, then based on the policy, the data will be put it in the right queue or schedule, that schedule are putting in the right queue. So there will be no packet loss for the voice packet, video packet, according to your policy. So understood this? Clear now? What is DSCP code? I'll put this here. DSCP code. Okay. So understand what is DSCP? DSCP is nothing but a field which is used for QoS to classify the data. Sandeep, clear? Any questions from Ashwita or Ranjita? Is this clear? Yeah, Ashwita, clear? Ranjita? Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir, clear.
Okay, madam. Okay, fine. So now we'll go to next field. The next field what we're discussing is total length. Total length is nothing but your header size and the data size. Generally, header size is 20 bytes. Huh? Data size will differ from technology. If you are using Ethernet, 1500 bytes. So this is your data size. Next is now three fields. Now these three fields I'm going to teach you now. Identification, flag, fragment, offset. Okay. These three fields, let us understand first. Now let me just put this diagram. Okay, now let us start. First, now we are going to discuss about three fields. What are three fields, sir? We have is okay. So first, let us draw a diagram for to understand this. Now we are going to study the identification of flag and fragment offset. For that, I'm going to draw a topology again. I'm just creating one hypothetical situation. Just explaining this. Okay. I'm taking three routers. Now I am connecting the two here. Okay, these three routers, let us see, name R1, R2, R3. The link bandwidth. Okay, the link bandwidth is this is for example 40 Mbps. Okay, now this is your 8 Mbps or now tell me how many KB, there's a question here, how many KB how many MB I can transfer in this MB. How many MB I can send download? For example, you have a 40 Mbps internet speed in your lab, if your home internet connection is there. How many MB you can download?
Maximum will be 40 Mbps.
40 Mbps is megabits per second, right?
Okay.
My question is, when you're downloading, you know, the computer uses 8 bytes, you know, computer is always in bit bytes. So how many MB I can download per second?
Yeah, it's 40 MB.
40 MB is your bits here, megabits. Wrong answer.
Okay. Okay, sorry. Okay. I mean, 40...
Understand the question, na? Question is, I am asking about how many MB you can download per second, download speed. The download speed is always in megabytes, not bits, okay? Your link is always in bits. The physical layer is comes in bits. The unit speed is bits. But when you talk about the computer download, right, it's always in bytes, megabytes, MBs. So how many MB I can download per second? For this, you have to use one simple formula. How many bits is one byte?
Is it 320?
No. How many bits is one byte?
8.
Okay, that's what I do. 8 bits is one byte. This is what everybody knows. Now I need to convert these bits into bytes. How do I convert? 40 divided by 8. How much I'll get? Understand? Are you able to understand this? Everyone? How I got this value?
Yeah, got it.
So now I can download 5 MB per second. Understood, Rashmita and Ranjita? How I got this value? Okay, Ranjita, clear? Rashmita, you're clear? Okay, fine. Now tell me, what is the bandwidth for 8 Mbps? How much I can download? per MB. How many MB can download per second?
1 MB.
That's clear now. So now let us take this. This is the basic RFCL. Then I want to send the data from PC1 to PC2, PC2, and the size is 4 MB, for example. Okay. Now R1 to R2, I can send it up to 5 MB. I can send it. Okay. Now what will happen is this particular R1 to R2, only one packet will go. One packet. That also we have one shot 4 MB can send. Okay. Now think like this: R2 to R3. Can I send one packet? No. So the size is maximum is 1 MB. So what I will do? I will again divide this 4 MB packet into 4 packets. 1, 2, 3, 4 packets. Okay. So this 4 packets, each packet I will put it in 1 MB. Okay, then I will send like this: packet 1, then packet 4, packet 2, and packet 3. I purposefully put the packets in out of order packet. Oh, this is called out of order. I'm not sending in order. I'm not sending first to packet 1, then packet 2, then packet 3, then packet 4. I'm sending out of order packet. What is out of order? It will not come in order. So the moment it receives that R3, what R3 will do is, R3 will again reassemble the packet. Reassemble will happen. After this, it will again send R3 to PC2 as one packet. That will be again 4 MB. Understand this process, right? This process is called what? Fragmentation. What is this process? This process is called fragmentation. So what is fragmentation? Fragmentation means dividing one packet into multiple sub packets. Okay. This is called what? Fragmentation. Dividing one packet into multiple sub packets. Why? To overcome the bandwidth limitation. So there are link bandwidth limitations, are there? No, link bandwidth limitations. We need to overcome that. There is no limit, bandwidth is not there. So what we will do? We will use this fragmentation technique and we will send the packet. Okay, this is called fragmentation. Now we are going to discuss about three fields. Okay, first field is identification field. So what is identification field? Identification field is basically, I am going to identify, when I am fragmenting, I am going to identify with the number. This number will help me to reassemble the packet. Identification field. In the identification field, what I am putting here, I am putting the number, which will help me to reassemble the fragmented data. Identification field. Okay, next. Fragment offset. In fragment offset, what happens? Okay, here what is the size of the fragmented packet? Like I divided here into 1 MB, 1 MB, 1 MB, no? It will be like this, 128, 64, 120, 32, 64, 128, 256, 512, 1024, 2048, like that. There is a 2 powers will be there. The 2 powers, they will actually divide the packet. So this fragmentation is nothing but your what size you are breaking the packet. One data, how much you are breaking. Next is fragment. In that we have something called flag. So flag is basically here, the third one I'm writing here, flag. Three fields we're discussing here, right? So flag is nothing but your allow or do not fragment. So do not fragment. Okay. So there are two things, on off. One, for example, one is on, zero is off. Don't do that. Something like that. Do not fragment. on off. Okay. Do not backbone. So, what I'm trying to do here is I'm just telling this guy, this router, see, this particular packet don't fragment. Why? We must not fragment for voice and video data. If you fragment and reassemble, your voice communication will fail. So voice or video, right? We must not fragment. You have to send as it is. Okay. If there is no bandwidth available, then the packet will be dropped. It will not be forwarded. So you have to select do not fragment field for voice and video video data. This is the three fields. Identification, to identify when you are breaking the data into small, dividing into small packets, the reassemble purpose, we put one value, one number, that is for identifying and reassembling in the proper order. Fragment offset is what size you are fragmenting. Then flag is allow or don't allow fragmented. Why you have to must not allow fragmentation? Because there are some applications which will not allow fragmentation and reassembling again, because it's a real-time application. If you do all the fragmentation, then that the application will fail. Due to that, do not fragment. This is called what? Three fields of fragmentation. So if you see this, we discussed about version, I told you, header length, type of service, quality of service, total length, these three fields we discussed. Next one we are going to discuss is time to live. So whenever a packet is generated, okay, and a packet is born, it has one value. That is called TTL, time to live. This is created by the OS. For example, TTL is 64. What is time to live? How many devices? So time to live means what? Hop limit. You can remember like this. How many hop means device? How many devices he can travel? It's not unlimited, right? He keep on going in all the devices, never end. So there is a limitation. So once in particular devices, if the packet got crossed, the packet has to die. Okay, like a human being's time to live is 100 years. After 100 years, human being has to die. There's nothing like you born, you can go continuously living, right? So there is a limitation for everything, but whichever is born. The same way, when the packet is born, they create one, put one limit. That limit is hop limit is called TTL, time to live. So what is TTL will do? Every packet, every device will have one counter will be running. So TTL minus 1. For example, the moment the packet reaches R1, TTL minus will happen. Then the TTL will become here. When it reaching to R2, the TTL will be 63. Then same way it will travel. It goes to multiple devices. Then one day the TTL will go to 0. Then the last of the packet TTL becomes 0. The packet drops. Packet drops or packet dies. The analogy is there. So understand now what is TTL? TTL is nothing but how many hops the packet can travel. Okay, so every device, the one minus one will happen. TTL minus one will happen. So in exam, right? In CCNA exam, minimum one question will come on this topic. Why I'm teaching this topic? Minimum one question will come on this topic. Very, very important question, TTL value. Okay, is this clear? Fragmentation and TTL is clear. Can I move forward? All good.
So, like, I have a question. In like, when a packet is routed from R2 to R3, what is the necessity to reassemble the packets? Because all the packets has the same size of data, but still you reassemble the packets. What is the necessary to reassemble, sir? Even though the packet size is same, and what is the necessary to reassemble?
See, when you are breaking the packet, right? Like for example, you are sending one document. Okay, think like this. Okay, you are taking Xerox. Okay, you are taking Xerox. We cannot take Xerox in one at a time. So you are removing the stapler and you are taking Xerox separately. Okay. Now take Xerox is taken now. But after Xerox is taken, you have to order it in phase number, right? You understand? You cannot take Xerox in one at a time. So you are removing the stapler and taking Xerox separately. After you take the Xerox, what you do again, it is not in order. You have to reassemble that in a number, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4 page number.
Yes.
So that is the process it is doing actually. The order, the Xerox is taken, but it is not in the order, out of order.
Mm.
One has to come first, two has to come second, then only the book will be readable, no? Data is not readable, right? Though data is there, but it's not readable, no? First, yes. Second has to come second, no? Then only,
yeah.
For example, you have a movie downloaded, right? The movie has to come first, no? It cannot be assembled. You understand, no? Shuffled, right?
Yeah.
So reassembling here is bringing in the order, that's it. You collected all the data, but it's out of order.
Yes.
So like how you after Xerox, how you put the papers in a proper 1, 2, 3, you know, page number.
Okay.
Clear, no?
Yes.
Okay, that is reassembly. Okay. Any other questions you have? Others?
The yeah. Reassembling is configurable, right?
Configurable means?
I mean, we can configure it as do not jumble the packets or send it like that. Send it the
way. Configurable means you can say that you want to do fragmentation or no, that's it.
Okay.
This mechanism will do fragmentation, defragmentation. Both is done by that mechanism. Okay. So what we can configure is we can tell the router to do, as you can do fragmentation or not. That's it. That is the one command is there. So by giving that command, it will stop fragmentation or it will do fragmentation. That's it.
Mm.
Understand, no?
Okay.
Yeah. Ashita, clear? Everyone clear, right?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. The next field we are going to see is protocol. Now remember, this is protocol is nothing but your L4 information. This is L3, right? The L3 means IPv4 is L3. Now L4, what is the protocol is running? If you are running TCP, in this field will have 6. If you are running UDP, in this field will have 17. If you are running ICMP, in this field we have 1. ICMP is 1. So something like that. So what L4 protocol we are going to use, that information will be stored in this field in the form of protocol number. Okay. Checksum is for error detection, source IP, destination IP for routing, and options if you want to add extra field, this is the real data. IPv4 is clear. Can you move forward? IPv6? Everyone? I can go IPv6, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, fine. So let us start. This is the protocol numbers. So as I told you, ICMP is 1, TCP is 6, UDP is 17. We have so many other protocols, CRE, IPsec, so many protocols are there. Just we have studied only these 3 parts. Okay, 1, 6, and 17. ICMP is the protocol which used for ping. Ping, you know, right? Ping is for verifying, the troubleshooting CLI tool to verify your L1, L2, L3, L4 is working fine. So for this ping command, we use ping application, we use ICMP protocol. Okay, the protocol number is for this is 1. Okay. So next I'm going for IPv6. For even IPv6. Uh-huh.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Like ICMP protocol doesn't have protocol, but because ICMP work messages where echo message port number of 7. But how come ICMP protocol number is 1?
What is that protocol ICMP has for? 7.
ICMP, that is in the second. Hello?
I understand. What is this 7?
7 is where ICMP works on echo messages. The echo messages port number is 7, but ICMP doesn't have particular protocol number. So I have a question, how come ICMP protocol has a protocol number?
What number is for ICMP? Protocol number you are saying, for ICMP?
Yeah.
Okay, let me check that. Okay, we'll go to IANA. Okay, how to check that? Go to IANA. Okay, protocol number, right? IANA protocol numbers. You can see that first one is what? See that TCP 6 ICMP. This is the RFC also. Given how ICMP works.
But ping is a service, right? Same.
Ping is a application.
It's a it's a application or service.
See, ICMP is used for trace route ping for so many applications to use. Okay, ICMP is a protocol. Okay, applications are ping, trace route, all these things. Understand, no? What she is telling is this is the header field, okay, and it has codes and types and codes, very very important, which we are going to discuss now. So what her question is, she is saying this is not a protocol. I don't know where she is. Where you studied this, Ranjita, right?
I studied it while I was doing my cyber security course, initiate course. Yeah.
Let me check that out. It's the fourth number. SMP has no ports. It is a protocol only. There is no port
control.
Okay. ICMP is a L4 protocol. Understand? It's not L7. L7 will have port. Understand? No. ICMP is not L7 protocol. ICMP is a L4 protocol. Understand? L4 means like TCP UDP. It is a transport layer protocol. Understand? No. It is not port number. If you just let me know what you have any document to share with me. And they are given here, see, the port number 7 you are given now.
Yeah, sure, I'll research
this, see, there is a value, there is a document here, let me go through. They are given some port number, 7 is, what is this port number, we'll understand. So, what is this TCP UDP port 7? So, Port 7
belongs to echo message.
That is echo message, understand that. So IANA. I'm using the IANA is the authority, right? I'm just using this IANA. So you see what is port 7 is. Yeah, it is there. Port 7. This is for echo, okay? What we are talking is ICMP. This is echo. You got it,
nah?
So ICMP is the L4 protocol. L7 protocol is echo. You got it? You understand it?
Yes.
So application, ping uses echo. That is L7. Now you are clear. ICMP, what I was talking, ICMP, you are saying echo is what ping is using. Right now? Echo request, echo reply. Correct. So ping is using, trace route is using. So that is your L7. Echo. Let us see what it is echo.
The echo is used to ping in order to check whether the system is online or not.
This is the echo. I'm giving you both RFC. Okay, you go through this. Okay, this is the authorized document. Different between. So what we are discussing is ICMP. ICMP is an L4 protocol, which is having protocol number. Echo is, what is echo? Echo is basically a service. Okay. Understand? It is using port number 7. Understand the difference, no? Echo is a service. ICMP is a L4 protocol. Okay? I think you got the answer, no? Okay, that is the difference. This is the question you are asking. So let me share both the RFC documents.
Okay, yeah.
Any other question?
ICMP uses echo, right?
Pardon me, sir?
ICMP uses echo.
ICMP ne ping ping
yeah okay ping uses
application
okay
like we have application called ping trace route you know they uses this protocols like L4 protocol is ICMP L7 is echo
yeah.
L7 is a service for services we have application service we have port numbers
okay
so I gave you both RFC 792 and 8262 this you can study and try to understand more details we'll get from them okay now where are we are discussing about we have finished L4 now we are going to L3 now L3 we are discussing IPv4 now we are studying L3 IPv6 so note down this fields and I'll explain you the function. Once you write down the fields, I'll tell you the function. Once it is done, just give D. We have total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 6, 7, 8 fields are there. IPv6 is 8 fields. Same function only the fields will change. That's it. So if you see IPv4, IPv6, same function, which is actually upgraded version, simpler version is IPv6. Once you note down the fields, just let me know IPv6 fields, give D, then we'll start the class. These are done. These are done. Send it in. Okay. Let us discuss now. So, what is version 3? If you know IPv4, same function. It will tell you what is the version IPv4, IPv6. Traffic class, the same thing. QoS, whatever DHCP we did, the same thing will happen in traffic class. Now, flow label is nothing but single field now for fragmentation and defragmentation part. We have created a single field. Field for that. Payload length, total length, header plus data. Next data information is information about extended header or upper layer information. And hop limit is nothing but the TTL value, source of the security and data. So for routing and real data. Now, what is the difference here is payload width. What the difference here is this one, next header length, and rest all is like same thing. IP version, traffic class, fragmentation, this is total length, the TTL value we know. So this extra thing, this next header is different here. Now what we did in IPv6 is, let us take like this. Now you have a L4 information. Now this is my put like this. This is my data. Okay. Now this data I want to send. I'm adding L4 in L4 header. So my L4 header is, for example, what is L4 header? TCP. TCP means my protocol is 6. Okay. Now TCP. Now I'm going to put L3 header. L3 header is IPv6, not IPv4. It is IPv6. In the IPv6, there are multiple fields are there. L3 header is IPv6. In that one field is next header. Okay. So what is this next header field? In the next header field, we will be having an option like in IPv4, we have a protocol field. You remember that protocol field? Protocol field tell you what is this L4 information. Like it is 6 means we put 6 here. But here we are going to use the concept called next header. Why next header is? Now in IPv6 there is no options field. If you remember this, just all we have something called options. You see here we have also have options here, right? To add extra fields in IPv4. But in IPv6 we don't have options field. Right, instead of options fields, what they did is they have created something called extended headers, IPv6 extended headers, IPv6 extended header, meaning I want to add some extra fields, I can create extended headers. How many extended headers I can create, how much extended headers I want. Now this next header field will have something called, if we have extended header, no, we can just send it like this. Okay, I'll put this. Yeah, I can send from here to here. The information will have, instead will have this next extended header field. Now this extended header field will have the L4 information. If we don't have a next one, then we have next one is L2 header. Header and footer. L2 header and footer. Right? It may be Ethernet or whatever technology you're using. Or FP fiber, FPGA, whatever technology you're using. Or WAN means SDLC. Okay? Or TPP. So the WAN protocol is TPP. So whatever technology you are using, L2 technology, LAN or WAN, so that information will be there in L2 header and footer. Now, this is the IPv6 extra one option they added. They removed the options field, they added something called extended header. In the IPv6 header, if you don't have extended header, obviously it will be directly connecting to L4. If you have extended headers, you will just mention the next header is extended header. From there you have one field in the extended header. It will take you to the IPv4. Understand this? What is this next header field in IPv6? So this is IPv6. Is this clear now? IPv6 is clear. Can I move to internet? Okay, IPv6 is clear, right? Can be clear. Can be clear.
Hello. So, one more thing. Hello.
Yeah, madam. Yeah, madam.
Actually, in IPv4 we have private and public range, right? In IPv6 we have anything?
Yes, we have something called a unique local, site local. I'll just show you that. We have that.
No, I am asking the range.
Range is there, that is called site local, unique local. Private we call, no, this one we don't call private IP address, public IP address. We call, okay. IPv6 address types, which I will get all those things. I'll just show you. Okay. Now we have something called, see, link local, yeah, unique local. Can you see unique local? This is equal to your private IP address, free address.
Okay.
Understand this?
If it starts from FC0D, it is private.
Yes, FC00/:// 7 and FBFFF. Generally, FC0 slow we use. Okay. So IPv6 is like
this public.
It's not like that. There are so many options are there. We can take this as a public, madam. Global unicast.
Okay. There's
no public private now. In IPv6, there is no terminology called public private. We call global unicast, unique local. Okay. So this is equal. If you want to compare with IPv4, you can compare like this. Private IP is Private IP is 3 IP, is this one unique local. Public IP, which is given from ISP, na, that is global unique. You have to pay money and buy. That is public IP, global unique. Okay? Understand, no? We have ranges for everything. So they have given, is IANA is given the ranges based on the service protocol will give. Is this clear? Without question, got clear? Okay, fine. Just put this for you so you can use this. Okay, so next I'm going for Ethernet. So I think it's, yeah, we got next Ethernet. This is done. IPv6 is done. Next Ethernet we are going. Ethernet has multiple versions, okay? Multiple versions of standards of Ethernet is there. In these standards, we are going to learn 802.3 standard Ethernet. It has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The total 7 fields are there. You can write down these fields. So we are adding data, you leave it. We are adding 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 fields. So make a note on this and just give the, I'll explain you one by one. Okay. Now we are just arrow mark this one only, okay? Take the only this one, which I put arrow mark, right? We'll discuss on that. Done. I think Ranjita is done. Yeah, Sandeep is done. Ashita is done. Okay, now we'll discuss on this. So we know that source means source MAC address, destination MAC address, length is total length. LLC is the information about the from how many what do you call that? One packet I took and I converted into bytes, and how many bytes I converted into frame. That information is there in LLC. Then data is, what is the data? CRC is that code, that 0x72, like that, the algorithm, no? Putting this data in the algorithm and finding the code and putting here. So CRC, this is the footer. CRC is the footer, let's say. Then these all are clear. Now what is new for us is preamble. What is preamble? Preamble is, to understand preamble, I take this example, this is topology. Now consider like this, this computer is, PC1 is sending data to, PC1 is sending data to PC2. So how the data will flow? Data will flow like 10, 10, 10, like this, it will flow. All right. Now, and the data is coming to R2. Right, how this computer will understand, how the computer will understand, PC2 will understand which data is, which is frame 1, next is frame 2. Now for example, I'm sending 5 frames. Frame means I'm talking in L2. If I say in same language in L3, I'll say packets, frame, packet. Whenever I speak in L2, I'll say frame. Okay, so this is bits. Now this is bits, right? So I'm sending in L1 is bits. Right on here, L1 we call bits. So this bits I am sending now, it is now, he has to understand frame. So this bits is having, for example, frame 1, frame 2, frame 3. 3 frames I am sending in this bits. Now the question is, how this PC2 will understand when this frame 1 end, frame 2 started? So he don't know, right? Continuously 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0 is coming. how you will understand where from frame 1 end frame 2 started. So for that, what we do, we created a special pattern of bits. So what is preamble? Preamble is special pattern of bits to identify beginning of the frame. Identify the start. I can say start of the frame. So where the second frame starts. Now, whenever a frame starts, this pattern will come. So, for example, I'm giving you an example. For example, 1000 ones, like 1111111, like 1000 ones is coming now. Then 1000 ones is coming continuously. PCT will understand frame 2 started, frame 3 started, frame 4 started. So, whenever he started receiving the frame, whenever he sees 1000 ones, he'll understand, okay, now frame 2 started, frame 3 started. So this special pattern of bits will help the PC2 to understand the new frame is started. Okay, one frame finished, second frame started. So this is called preamble. Understand this? What is preamble? This is called Ethernet. Okay, Ethernet is clear. Next we will go to last one. I think ARP and ICMP. So let us take ARP first. What is ARP full form? Address Resolution Protocol. What it does? Address Resolution Protocol.
Hello.
Yeah. Tell me.
In this course, we are not going to learn the IPv6 detail.
What do you want to learn IPv6?
I mean, the representation and all. There is some format and all. How to represent? There are some rules. How to read that IPv6 address and all. So, are you going to learn that, or it's just basics of IPv6?
Talking about. This one. Link local. This one you want?
Not this. Some rules, right? I mean, the colon and all. I mean,
I teach that all. This I'm teaching. Everything I teach. Okay. We have unique local is there. Link local is there. How do you build this link local? Everything I teach you. Okay.
I'm just asking.
I'll teach. I'll teach you all the different types and what are the different types is there and how to call, why this number is coming, okay. So you will get an idea, fair idea. If you and I will show you how to configure also. If you want to see, I'll show you how to configure also. I'll just open a packet reference for you. Okay. I'll just give you some fair idea. See that if you want extra information, let me know. I will teach you that also. Okay.
Okay. Sure.
See, basics I'll make it clear. Apart from that, you want extra something, you have to tell me. Otherwise, I'll be covering all the basics. That's why I'm starting from N+. I'm not directly teaching you attacks,
Okay.
So the purpose of teaching you N+ is, this is the reason. I know that people don't know so many things in base N+, so they will struggle. Okay. So I am making the foundation very strong, very clear. So when we go higher and higher, easy for us to pick up faster. So we'll cover this topic, okay? How to get this value, what is this, what is the loop local, what is this number, this coming, everything like this. Now we are actually here now, right? Where are we now?
In internet.
I'll tell you where it is coming. So we are here, right? IPv6. When we come to this this part, no? This part, IPv6 basically, this is the thing.
Okay.
We are here now. We are coming to here. Okay, I'm teaching you this. I finished today. So tomorrow I'll be teaching you the design, network design. Okay.
Okay.
Then I'll teach you the topologies, cables and connectors, IPv6, VLSM, then finally IPv6 sub basics. Then I'll teach you the different devices and how the devices work, how router works, how switch works, you know, and what is broadcast domain, collision domain. This all I'll teach you. So this will cover our 10 plus. Okay. Then I will start opening. I'll open my security plus syllabus and start covering security plus. Understand?
Yeah, sure.
Security plus will be completely different genre. You know, it's not like it talking like this. They'll be talking about attacks, different types of malwares, attacks. You know, but it's totally different genre. This is the design, network design. I want to teach you some basics. Okay. You let me know if you need to learn anything extra about this. I will cover maximum everything in this. If you want to extra something, let me know. I will prepare and teach you that also. Fine. So where are we now? We are actually discussing ICMP and ARP. So I'm starting ARP now. Okay. ARP is Address Resolution Protocol. Address Resolution Protocol we'll discuss about. What is Address Resolution Protocol will do is, if I give a, okay, I'll just say name called Barking Dog. Remember this word. Okay. What is, if anybody asks you Address Resolution Protocol, it's called Barking Dog. Okay, what is Barking Dog? Now, consider like Sandeep is staying in MG Road. Okay, I know his name is Sandeep, he's staying in MG Road. Okay, but I don't know his door number. Which door number he's staying in MG Road? Okay, now what I will do, I will give his name and I'll tell him this interface. This interface means this road he is staying. Okay, now what this ARP will do is ARP will start barking. Okay, it will start sending. For what I did now, I give IP address. IP address to whom? ARP, Address Resolution Protocol, that is Barking Dog. What ARP will do? ARP will send ARP broadcast in that interface. Which are interface I put now? In that interface, it starts sending broadcast. So when I send what ARP broadcast means, like this analogy, if you take now, he is shouting in the road. He'll put a auto and he'll put a mic and start shouting. Sandeep, who is Sandeep? He shouts. Okay. Now, when Sandeep receives this broadcast, he will say, yes, I am Sandeep, what do you want? Now, the moment he receives the reply, what ARP will do is, ARP will come and tell me, ARP will come and write down, he has one record, it's called ARP table, okay? He'll maintain that, Sandeep is staying in door number 7. He'll maintain the record. Now, next time when I want to check, I'll go see the record. Now, I know where Sandeep door number is. Understand this story, the analogy? The same way here. Now I want to know the MAC address of a MAC address of a IP address. I know IP address, but I don't know the machine MAC address. So what I will do, I will give this IP address to the ARP protocol. What ARP protocol will say? ARP protocol will send ARP broadcast. It says, this is the broadcast. Who has, like this it will go, 1.1, for example, or 1.1, okay, 1.1. Now, 1.1 machine, it may be a device or router, he will give reply. Yes, I am 1.1. So by the broadcast request, ARP request, ARP broadcast request, once a reply comes, right, ARP reply comes, so received ARP reply, once you receive the ARP reply, what it does, it updates something called ARP table. Update ARP table. So what will be there in the ARP table? ARP table will have two things: IP address, MAC address. Okay, IP address is this one means 1.1 means what is the MAC address? Now I want to know the MAC address. How I'll check? I don't know the MAC address. I'll go to command prompt. I will type. Okay, I will type what? ARP minus A. This is my PC. How to get the ARP table? This is the ARP table. I get a command for PC. Now, in this 1.1, I got the MAC address. It is already maintaining. ARP is maintaining the MAC address. It dynamic means automatically find out. So I'll copy this. Then I will put it here. This is my ARP table MAC address. Now, next time when I want to send the data, I will destination MAC address, I'll put this MAC address. Destination MAC default gateway is 1.1. Whenever I want to go to outside of my network, my destination source IP is my interface IP, interface MAC address, source MAC, destination MAC will be 1.1 MAC address. So this is the way ARP works. So ARP is what we call ARP, address resolution protocol. So what it is resolving? It is resolving from IP address to MAC address. If you IP address, it will give MAC address. ARP is clear? Any questions in ARP? Can I move to ICMP? Okay, any questions you can ask me.
There is something called reverse address resolution protocol also, right?
There are so many ARPs there. ARP types you want to know. We have so many ARPs. Yeah. ARP types also. There are so many types of that. I'll show you that. This is what I'm talking about, right? ARP, reverse ARP, gracious ARP, proxy ARP. Okay, I'll just give you this link. You can just go through this one by one. So there is first ARP I told you. Next we have something called the first ARP mode is one ARP. Second is reverse ARP is there. Okay, here what will happen? It is a protocol which used to local IP address, it's a gateway from the gateway. So the mission is, well, we can just, so what it does basically is send machine in the local network to request for the IP address for the gateway routing protocol router. Okay, ARP table. From the gateway router ARP you want to get, we'll use this reverse ARP. Okay. So in the network administrator creates a table in the gateway router which is used to map the MAC address to the corresponding IP address. A new machine is set up in any machine which doesn't have the memory to store. Okay. Memory to store the IP addresses needs an IP address for one use. The machine, so the machine sends ARP, reverse ARP broadcast packet, which contains its own MAC address, okay, in both sender and receiver address field. So what will happen this time? The special host configured inside the local is called the reverse ARP, is responsible to reply to these kinds of broadcast packets. Now, where we are using it? You don't have a record to maintain your own ARP table, then we'll use this reverse ARP. Understand this? Generally, we use this for nowadays. It is not used. See, ARP is not used because we must have configured the boot. Understand? No?
Okay, got it.
The same way we have in ARP is there, proxy ARP is there. Okay, in an interview, they'll ask you what is proxy ARP, what is in ARP. I'll share you this. You can go through this. Okay, but different ARPs are there. But basically, what we play with this ARP table only. We'll send some ARP request, we'll get that ARP request based on, if I don't know the IP address, you tell me the IP address. If I know I MAC address, I don't know the IP address. You tell me the IP address now. First I gave IP address, you gave me MAC address. Now reverse I'm asking. That is reverse ARP. You got it, na? Okay. So I'll just put this also. Then go through different types of ARP types. Proxy ARP, in ARP, and the way ARP. Okay. Gracious ARP is advanced scenario, which is something computer is going putting up network interface first time. It automatically broadcasts with MAC address and entire network. After gracious ARP, the computer is known as every switch in the every switch DHC, all of DHC server to know where the IP address is requested. So this is easy with gracious ARP. Okay. This gracious is sending to everybody. Okay. Different ARP. Sandeep, you got your answer? Can I move forward?
Yeah, friend, I got it.
Okay. So next we are going to see the last protocol is ICMP. Now ICMP is here, as I told you, ICMP is a L4 protocol. The protocol number is 1. ICMP uses a service called Echo. Echo's port number is 7. Okay, so that we discussed till now. Now we are going to understand the fields, ICMP header fields. Okay, so when you say ICMP header format, we have Wikipedia. Well, let me take Wikipedia. Okay, this is the header format. We have important is a checksum, you know, for error detection. We have important two fields are there, type and code. Okay, why we need to understand this type and code? Because based on this type and code only, we are going to do troubleshooting. The general troubleshooting is the link is up or down. Like, for example, I'll ping now here 192.168.1.1. I'll get reply now. This is my TTL. Time to leave. Okay, I'm getting a reply. Now, if I'm not getting a reply, for example, 1.10, I'll type. I'll not get a reply because there's no device called 1.10. He's saying that host is unreachable for me. I don't know where it is posted. Okay. Now I'll type. This is generally what I'm doing. But the point here is, when I'm typing this, what is the information we are sending and receiving? Is this field, these two fields are there. Now I know it is not reachable, right? But why it is not reachable? How to find out? We can use these two fields and we find out. For example, you take this type number 3. Destination and reachable. Now this course is there. No course will tell you, but the code will tell you why it is not unreachable. Okay. Now this is the level we are going to study now. Now see this. It says it is unreachable because network is not reachable. Zero means code. See type 3 code 0 means what? Because network is not reachable, you are not unreachable. Now type 3 code 1 means network is reachable. We are able to go to the network, but in that network, that particular host is not reachable. That is type 1. Now, network and host is reachable. What protocol you are trying to know, that protocol is blocked. You are able to go to the host, the computer, but the protocol is blocked. That is type number, code number 2. Now, port also protocol is there, but you are not able to reach the application. The application port is blocked. Then, due to fragmentation, you are not able to reach it. The fragmentation flag is set. Do not fragment. DF flag means do not fragment. Do not fragment flag is set. So your package is getting dropped. Because of fragmentation flag is set, you are not reachable. So like that, so many reasons are there. So these things, right, we'll learn. For this, we use this code. So this is the two fields. So what are the fields you are going to study now? Type and code. Okay. So in IP, let me write down here. In ICMP, in ICMP, you are going to study mainly two fields. What other fields you are going to study? Type and code. Okay. So, for example, type 3 is destination unreachable. Why it is unreachable? We will use this. Use this code 0 means what, code 1 means what, like that. We have multiple things. Okay, so code 0 means what is the reason? The reason is network unreachable. Network is not network unreachable. Network, let me put network. This is host. This is net, for example, this is protocol. This thing I am right only. Port, something like that. Right? Okay. Port, port, yeah. Then I put 4, I'll put 4 as input, which is another. So this is your fragment. DF is set. DF flag is set. So that's it, because it's this DF flag is set, it is not reachable. So, like that, we'll come to know that why this packet is not reachable using this types and code. Code, especially on code. Okay. So this is the fields we have ICMP. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to show you this. I'll capture and show you. Let's see if we're able to do that. So we use a tool called Wireshark to capture this ICMP packet. Okay. Just give me a minute. I will just show you that, then we'll end the project. I'm loading this, installing this, loading this Wireshark. Now it has multiple, I have VM, VMware is running, and multiple NACC. I'm going to use wireless because I'm connecting my laptop through wireless. So I'm using wireless. I'm going to capture this wireless NIC details. Now, in this wireless, so many things are coming, TCP, UDP, so many things are going on. You see that, right? Now I'm going to use, I'm going to filter with ICMP. Or I can see that the ARP is there. Yes, see, ARP is there. who has 182.168.1.3 tell 1.1, like that this is sending broadcast, ARP broadcast is sending. You see that, right? Who has this? So this is your ARP. Now I'm going to see ICMP. ICMP is our thing. Now in ICMP, I'm going to ping, just ping, ping 8.8.8.8. Okay. Now you can see that backend. I'm able to see the ping now. So now I'll stop this capture. I'll stop it. Now I'll analyze this. Okay, we're going to analyze this now. Okay. Now see. ICMP send echo request, echo reply. Echo request, echo reply. This is ping application. Ping is using echo service. Echo request, echo reply, echo request. That is four times it is sending echo and reply. Now every time when you see this, this is your LLC. Logical link layer details. Bits to frame, bytes to frame, frame to bytes. So 74 bytes is make one frame. And these all are the encapsulation type. What is the technology you're using? L1 cable. So implant type is there. Everything is there in the LLC. Okay. Now, this is a Ethernet header, source MAC, decision MAC, and type of the Ethernet. Okay, that's it. Then we have IPv4 header. This is version. Header length is 20 bytes. DHCP, your quality of service. Total length is 60 bytes. Yeah, identification is there. Flag fragment offset is 0. Okay, you see the flag. I see this now. Do not fragment, not set. More fragments, not set. So fragmentation is allowed. So do not fragment is set means we cannot allow to fragment. Then time delay is 128. ICMP. No, see the protocol is the L4 protocol is ICMP. The number is 1. This is the checksum value. Then this is the source IP and destination IP. This is the information available in IPv4 header field. Next, I'm going to ICMP. Now, ICMP type is 8, code is 0. Let us see that. Now, let us go to Wikipedia. What is type 8? Code 0 will understand. So, type 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 8, 8 is a code request. Type is 8. And what is code 0? Used for ping. Understand this? So this is basically it's saying I have reused echo request. And what is the reply is coming now? The reply is again a type 0 code 0. So reply K. Now this is your checksum and other details. What is the data I'm sending? This is the data I'm sending. You can see this data. The data what the ping application is sending is ABC. Same data, whatever ABCD it send, it has to come back. Understand? This is the way I am verifying my L1, L2, L3, L4. Okay, you have any questions on this? Is this clear?
Yeah, Prem.
Okay. Sanjita, clear? Shweta?
Can we try bringing some unreachable network and check the Wireshark packets?
You want to do that?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll try that. So, I will ping. Okay. I'll start the capture. It's only sending no response phone. So let us try something. So there's no reply coming. Now I type one more. Eater. I think I'll get the reply on this. Yeah, this is coming. And do one thing, we can do like this. Start one continuously. But I cannot stop it. If I stop this, no, my problem, I tell you. If I stop this, you will lose my internet connection. You can stop this actually. the problem will be I lose the internet connection, no? It is pinging now, right? I can stop it and I can show you this unreachable. But the problem is, I will lose the
interface something. You can think on private IP, maybe.
You can stop it. I'll try that. No response for this one. You see that? No response.
No, I was just curious to know about the code. What code will
code will come, but for that we need to have this destination host unreachable. Okay. So to do that, we need to if I create Unistory lab, no, there I can show you all. Because I can create a whole topology in that, I can shut down the interface and I show you that destination host unreachable will come back end. You can capture and see that. Understand, no? This we can do. Okay. Yes, it is possible. Because in my machine, PC will say there's no response. That's it.
Correct.
Okay. So let's see, we'll try this. So starter, we'll take this control, open, and configure it. So what I'm going to configure is R1 configure T interface 0/0 IP 1.0.0 2.0.2.0 no structure then interface I'm configuring for R1 it's 0/0 IP will be and IP root. Okay, this is my configuration for R1. This then start one do it. See, I did something wrong here. Start one and do it. Here the start one. Okay. Copy this. This is our one. This is done now. So we have connected. So R2 will go. I'm configuring 1.2 and 2 patch will be copy. Without. Yeah, I got it now. So I'm able to ping now. See, now I'll ping it. Ping from R1, I'm pinging to 1.1.1.1. Sorry, 2.2.2.2. This is nothing but my R2 loopback. Success, right? Now what I'm going to do, I am going to ping only. Then I give 1000 counter. Login. Ping. I'll set the zero. I'll try to add and start this. A pair of ping, IP, IP, 2.2.2.2, 1000 times ping, and this one. I'll start the Wireshark also now. Open Wireshark here. ICMP sending hello. Some loop is going on. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to start the okay. I'll start R1 in the So I'll filter this with the finger. ICMP. Okay. Now I'm going to ping now. Then when I'm pinging, I will stop this. I'm stopping this. This one. What do you call it? Interface. So the interface will go down. The destination host and disable it. First it has to ping, then interface goes down, this time it will come. We'll see that happening now. Okay, so pinging now. So then I will just say shut. U came, right? Can you see U? U is unreachable. Now we got U now. I got here, message no unreachable. I'll stop this. Now I will show you this. Can you see this? This is unreachable, host unreachable. Sandeep, you're able to see this?
Yeah, Prem.
Host unreachable. It's clearly telling you you're able to go to the network, but the host is unreachable.
Yeah, can we see the code in that?
Code.
Yeah.
Yeah. The code is 0 is coming here. So what has to come now?
After itself is not reachable, right? Yeah. Destination not reachable.
Yes.
Okay.
Understand, no?
Yeah.
This is the capture. Like that, you can come to know that what is free.
Okay. Yeah,
your question got answered, right?
Yeah. I just wanted to see the code. I mean,
we can do multiple things here. Now we can actually create one network and I can show on the whole thing. Like that, you can do it.
Yeah. Correct.
We can do this in packet tracer. Depends on that, we'll find out. So you want to see that ICMP packet wire shot. One they are showing. I want to show you some different ports. Yeah, let's see here now. You see this? This is the one you are asking, na?
Yeah, I was asking this.
This one, right?
Yeah.
The general one. 00, whatever we saw now. I'm just putting unreachable. Then you'll get here code 3.
Okay.
This one you are telling, na?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So this is the one. Destination unreachable has to come. So you port unreachable. Now we saw like we saw here is host unreachable. No? Like that, you show port unreachable here in the capture. Wireshark capture. Understand, no? So this is the one. You will get here 3-3. Correct. This is you are looking, right?
Yeah, yeah.
I give this to you. But you need to create that scenario. Understand the point, no?
Yeah, yeah. I mean, in troubleshooting, right? So.
Yeah, troubleshooting.
Troubleshooting. Yeah. So that's why I just wanted to know. I mean, which code represent what?
Okay. And you end up for the day.
Yeah, sure, Prem.
I think Ranjita left out.
Yes, she told like me.
Okay, madam. So anyhow, I am recording the session. I'll share with you. Okay, you have any other question? Okay. So Ashish, you are clear now, right?
Yeah, yeah. I'm clear, Prem.
Okay. Okay then. So then we'll wind up for the day. Today, tomorrow we'll start with the design part. Tomorrow we are going to study enterprise network design. Okay.
Sure.
And I'll teach you the enterprise network design. Why I'm teaching? I'm going to teach you the security architecture. To understand the security architecture, first you have to understand network design. Okay.
Okay.
Understand, right? Once you understand the network design, then I will teach you the security architecture. Is this clear? Tomorrow we'll cover this. Start from design tomorrow. Okay, madam. So we'll see you tomorrow then. Take care, bye.
Sure. Take care, Prem. Yeah. Thank you so much for your
Take care. Thanks. Have a nice day. Take care.
Thank you so much.